you're looking for revelation, if you're looking for knowledge, and if you're looking for a prophetic word, look no further. Get ready for a new hour, for a new anointing with the powerful Prophetess Cynthia Clark.
And his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Amen. I want to say thank God for you and you for tuning in to a new hour for a new anointing. Amen. On Comcast 20, Cable 8. Amen. And I thank God today for Elder Choir Boy Bell and his lovely wife, Sister Yolanda Bell, the producers of BGN TV Gospel. Amen to God. I just thank God. I thank God. I'm so excited to be in the land of the living. I'm excited that you are in the land of the living. Amen. God is a good God. Amen. I'm not going to hold my time up. I want to get into this word. Amen. But for them that are watching, I have three of these books left, and it's called Don't Mess With Me. Who Do You Think You Are? Amen. A great book written by Detroit-owned Wanda J. Burnside. Amen. The first three I want to sow into your life. Amen to God. And to them, amen, you write me or call me and let me know that you want a book. Amen to God. And also, I have to them that are saved and having uncertainties about, amen, their walk with God, having uncertainties, amen, that am I really saved, or I don't feel like I'm saved, or is it something that I should do to be saved? Is it something I'm supposed to be doing? Amen. And it lets you know that it's not according to your righteousness, but it's according to the righteousness of God. Amen. All of my information will be at the end of the broadcast. Amen. And you can call me, write me, Facebook me, email me, amen, for prayer, for literature. All you got to do is get in contact with me. Amen to God. Let us go to the Word of God in prayer. Father, I just thank you so much for your loving kindness. I thank you for your mercies, and I do thank you for your grace. For this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I thank you, Father, for those that are watching. Some may be needing salvation or to draw closer to you, healing or be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Father, whatever it is, peace or joy in their home, in their mind, in their spirit, I'm praying today that you will honor their request. I pray today in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Holy Ghost of the living God, through me speak the words that will bring life and will heal and deliver from out of fear and destruction, as only you can. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen and amen. It is a good thing to give thanks to our God. It is a good thing to sing praises unto our King. Amen to God. On last the broadcast, I got so cut up, I got caught up, I got so compelled, amen, to cry out to you to give your life to Jesus Christ and to them that know him, amen, to draw closer to him, amen. And if you're a backslider, my cry unto you is to ask God to heal you of your backsliding condition. Amen. You got to realize that there's nothing too hard for our God. It is him that we live, move, and we have our being in him. Amen to the living God. We're going to go back to that same scripture, and I'm going to calm down prayerfully by the grace of God. Amen. So that we can get some understanding in what God is saying in this word. The Bible said, in all thy getting, get understanding. Amen. And the scripture is 2 Timothy. We're going to deal with the latter part of 2 Timothy 2 and 25. Amen. And the word of God says, if God perhaps will give them repentance to the acknowledging of the truth. Amen. And those that have been following the broadcast know, amen, that we have been talking about repentance. Amen. Reviewing your actions, reviewing your thoughts. Amen. Having a change of mind about life, having a change of mind about God. Amen to the living God. Having a change of mind about things are going to become better because I will put my trust in God. Having a change of saying, I'm no longer going to do what I used to do. Amen to God, because I know the difference from right or wrong. Amen, but I'm going to repent and I'm going to make this a personal commitment, no matter who is right and no matter who is wrong. Amen to God, but I'm going to make a choice. I'm going to step up to the plate. I'm going to make a stand and say, Jesus, you forgive me. Whether those, my friends or my family, choose to come or go, amen, I'm going to make my own personal commitment to repent. Amen, that I might be healed in my mind, healed in my spirit, healed in my body, that my whole life would change. That's the beginning of coming into salvation, is the basic preparation to be saved. It said, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. And this particular scripture, Paul was writing to Timothy. He was talking to them that the servants of the Lord, amen, don't be so harsh and don't be so hard, because we got to win souls. The Bible says, he that is wise winneth souls. He says, strive to be patient. Work on being patient, because there are so many. There may be some out there watching right now, amen, that don't believe in God. And it's like, I'm tired of the church people. And man, I tried it and it don't work. But I'm coming to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen to the living God. I'm coming to you with long suffering. I'm going to wait on you. I'm going to be patient with you. Hallelujah. I'm going to be gentle with you, because my determination, a lot of time we talk in the kingdom of God, their assignment, my assignment, that you be saved. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My assignment, hallelujah, that you be baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. So the Bible says in 2 Timothy 2:25, that God will give them repentance by me being meek with you, by me being long-suffering with you, by me instructing you that Jesus Christ is the hope of glory. He's the one that died for your sins. Amen to God. He was wounded for your transgressions. He was bruised for your iniquities, and the chastisement of your peace, for you having peace, was upon him. Amen. And by his stripes, through the blood of Jesus Christ, through the wounds and through that he been ostracized, amen, you are healed. Your home is healed. Your mind is healed. Your body is healed. He paid the price. Amen. All you have to do is believe it, receive it, and repent. Amen to God. He said that God peradventure perhaps will give them repentance. Amen. All good and perfect gifts come from God. Amen. It's not an easy thing to repent. It's not an easy thing to tell somebody that you're sorry. Amen. It's a gift that comes from God. It's a hard thing, amen, you in the house of God, or we call it the church, and the preacher preaching, and he's right in your house talking about this, and you know, you feeling as if the preacher is pointing at you or picking at you, amen, and then he began to say, give your life to Jesus Christ, amen, and it just seemed like a hard thing, amen, but today we destroy that yoke by the anointing of Jesus Christ, amen, that God will give you repentance, amen, amen. So a lot of times, the reason why, and God had to give me this understanding, the reason why people don't repent, because he hasn't given them that gift. Amen to God. Because in that case, I would have repented years and years and years ago. But God came in. The Holy Ghost, amen, transmitted the spirit of repentance, asking God to forgive me of my sins. Amen. And that's what we're here to do today, that the Holy Ghost, amen, will transmit unto you from heaven the spirit of repentance, the spirit of godly sorrow that worketh unto repentance, recognizing, amen, that you are wrong, you you are a sinner, amen, and Jesus Christ died that you might be saved by his grace. Amen to God. So that to the acknowledging of truth. Repentance brings forth an awareness of your conscience of the reality of Jesus Christ. It makes you aware. Once you ask him to come into your life, amen, then he's the light of salvation. He's your deliverance. Amen. Things begin to look different. I remember giving my life to Jesus Christ. Amen. Things just became different. Amen. Just looking through these eyes. Amen. God gave me a sight, a brand new sight. Amen. The Bible said I once was lost. I once was blind, amen, but now I see the blind man was healed, amen, from his blindness, amen. He began to see things, amen, and that's what so many of us, the Bible said that the world is blinded by the gods of this world, amen, and Jesus Christ come that you may have sight and you may see life, amen, whole totally different from the way you see it. Amen to God. Repentance cleanses your emotions on how you perceive truth in the past. There was a time, amen, that you didn't believe. You didn't want to hear about God. Amen. But once you receive the gift of repentance and once you allow Jesus Christ to come into your life, amen, the way you used to believe, amen, you don't believe anymore. Why? Because truth has come in. Amen. That's what repentance is. It's bringing a clarity. It's bringing an understanding because Jesus Christ, amen, you become a new creature. You old things have passed away. The old ways of your thinking, the old ways of your saying, your conversation, your mannerism, everything changes. Glory to God. Why? Because God has given you repentance, acknowledging or confessing or admitting the existence, the reality, or the truth. Amen. Acknowledging is accepting responsibility to change your way of thinking. That's what it does. So that perhaps to them that oppose, to them that are not saved, to them that been wrestling with God, and you know, amen, that God has been dealing with you. Praise the Lord. Amen. And as he give you repentance, it brings an acknowledging. Oh yeah, I've heard about it. Glory to God. But now, because you have given your life over to Christ, you can confess truth. Amen. It's as you accepting responsibility to change, or your way of thinking changes. Truth is reality, actuality, a statement proven to be accepted as true. For instance, the Word of God. St. John 1 says, in the beginning was the Word. Amen. That's what truth is. It's a statement proven to be or accepted as true. Amen. That's what repentance, it causes you to accept the Word of God. Once you repent, any man that is born again is a new creature. Amen. All things have passed away. So it allows you, amen, to God to accept what is true. Accept the Word of God. Amen. Because you have an incorruptible seed now. Amen to God. And that seed, amen, planted in you, it comes forth and it gives you life. Amen to God. Jesus said, I come that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Life. Don't you want life today? Glory to God. Amen. Don't you want your household to change? Don't you want your husband to change? Don't you want your wife to change? Glory to God. Amen. A lot of time when we in relationships or we may be on our jobs, amen to God, we may have unrepentant sin. We may have said something or sometimes even think wrong. Amen to God. That's why the Bible said, you go and get that thing right. Get it right with your husband. Get it right with your family. Get it right with your co-worker. Get it right with your sisters and your brothers. Amen to God. Because it brings about a change. Amen. It makes you feel good. Amen. You may have sickness in your body, but because of repentance, amen to God, your body becomes healed. You become delivered. You become free. Amen to God. The Bible said you must be born again in order enter into the kingdom of heaven. You got to be born again. Amen. Don't let the sun go down. Amen. Don't let Jesus Christ come. And amen, you won't go back with them. You will say, well, evangelist, how do I go back with Jesus? The basic preparation, repentance. Lord, I'm a sinner. Backsliders, Lord, forgive me. Heal me from my sins. Deliver me. You may be in the house of God. You may be going to church. You've been going to church. You may be on an auxiliary board, but you don't have a relationship with Jesus. This is your opportunity today to say, Lord, forgive me. Have mercy upon me. Come into my life. Amen to God. True, Jesus said that I am the way. St. John 14:6. He said, I am the way and I am the truth. That's what repentance begins to, you begin to acknowledge the truth. And he said, the truth. The truth. The is emphasizing or identifying that God is above all truth. That's why I said the truth. Amen to God. You go into a courtroom and say, you know, you tell the truth. You tell the truth. You tell that which is above a lie. The truth is above a lie. Jesus said that the devil is a liar and he's a father of all lies. So that means that Jesus Christ is above Satan. The truth. You got a lie and you got a truth. You got many religions out here that don't bring joy. Amen. You got it's just an escape goat. It's just a cover up. But Jesus, serving Jesus, it's not a religion. It's a relationship. Can't you see the joy that's upon me? Can't you see the glory of God? Amen. That's upon me. Amen. It's not because of religion. It's because of relationship. You got to have a relationship with the truth. In this case, the truth is a person. He's God. He come to exemplify, he's the express image of the Father. And that's what he come to reveal to us. He came to reveal to us. He come to manifest to us what the will of the Father is. The love and the peace and the joy. That's what we get out of Jesus. Amen. You might be rich. You may have a whole lot of money and you may be tormented. That's why it's so important to give your life to Jesus. He's not going to take away your substances. He's the one that gave it to you. Whether you acknowledge it or not, it is Jesus that has blessed you abundantly. But the true abundance life is living in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. That's true abundance. When you got Jesus on the inside, and no matter what's going on in your life, you'll find peace. If Wall Street, I'm talking to the business people, if Wall Street crash, no matter what, you'll have peace. You won't be ready to jump off, glory to God, the buildings or commit suicide, amen, or kill your family and kill yourself. But you'll find peace and you'll have hope to know if he did it before, he'll do it again. That's what Jesus comes to do. He said, in this world, it's much trouble. In this world, it's much tribulations. Amen. But he said, be of good cheer, for in him there is peace. Peace. He come to give his people peace. There are so many things that is going on out there. The days are evil. The times are wicked. But we have the truth, which is Jesus. He emphasized. He identifies himself. As we see the trees, and as I'm standing here breathing, I'm not breathing on my own. You're not seeing through your eyes on your own. It's a gift from God. Sight is a gift from God. Hearing is a gift from God. Repentance is a gift from God. Breathing is a gift from God. Because all things were made by him, and without him, nothing was made. He's the creator of all things. There was nothing made without God. And a lot, and here it is. There's a damnable doctrine saying that they done it. They created it. They made it. I did this. That's a lie from hell. That's why Jesus said he is the truth. He's above everything and anything that whatever other people say or what other people do. He's a person. Jesus. He's a person. He came here on earth just like you and I. The Father loved us that much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth shall not perish but have everlasting life. The Father loved you just that much. And other religions don't call him Father. They call him God. That's why they cannot perceive of God having a son, because they don't have that relationship through Jesus Christ to call him Abba, Father. Many of you are watching, know the Lord's Prayer. Our Father. He's our Father who are in heaven. He's our Father. And that's why we that are believers can understand the Father has a Son. Jesus Christ is God. But he's the Son of the Father. You say, well, how can that be? Well, you give me a reason, how can it not be? Because God can do whatever he wants. He can take the breath in, put breath in our bodies, and he can take breath out of our bodies. And you all know that because we got loved ones that are lost. They have died and gone on. Where do death come from? Where do life come from? How do I lift my hands? How is all of this possible? It's by Jesus. It's by the Father. It's in the Holy Ghost. And we're going to talk about the Holy Ghost later. We're going to get into all, we're going to deal with the basics. You remember you growing up and you used to go to church, amen, and the preacher would talk about things, amen, that we don't hear today. But I have an assignment to tell you about Jesus, forgiveness, repentance, the Holy Ghost, and living for Christ until he come back. Because Jesus Christ is coming. He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. And I'm here by the grace of God, hallelujah, to admonish or to invite you to come to Christ. I'm here to ask you, to plead with you, to give your life to Jesus Christ. Because he is the way, and he is the truth, and he is the life. We're going to get back in two more of this, amen, because we got to talk about this thing. We got to get some understanding. Who is Jesus? And how do I receive Jesus? Amen to God. Amen. I just thank God for you. You and I'm praying today, amen, that you would give your life to him. We can take a moment and say, Jesus, repeat after me if you were sincere. Jesus, come into my life. Forgive me, for I am a sinner. I believe that you are the Son of God. And I want you to show me this truth that this lady is talking about. Show me that you are the truth. And that you are God, and beside you, there is no other God. Amen. If you said this prayer, amen, I'll be more than happy to send you this literature. Amen. You need Bibles. Amen. I'll be more than happy to send you Bibles. I want a few of you all to take the time and call me. This book is written by a great woman of God, Wanda Burnside. Don't mess with me. Who do you think you are? This book is written, it's complimented with scriptures, and it's written for people that's always been picked on, and but you're being kind, amen, but it's complimented with the word of God to bring you hope, to give you grace, amen, to allow you to stand and to make it. Amen to God. So all the information is at the end of the screen, amen, and you can also check us on demand at prophetessgospel.com. Amen. If you want to see this broadcast or other broadcasts again, amen, that comes on Comcast 20. Amen. And I want to say thank you so much. God bless you. Amen. And I'm looking forward to hearing from you in Jesus' name. And remember, the best is yet to come. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. Thank you again for tuning in. For those that have been watching the broadcast on Fridays at 12 noon, we're moving. Amen. We're moving on up to July the 7th at 5:30 p.m. Tell a neighbor, tell a friend. Amen. And also, you can catch us on demand on BGNTVGospel.com. God bless you. God smile upon you in Jesus' almighty name. Once again, that's every Tuesday at 5:30 p.m. starting July the 7th. Amen to God. I want to see you at the TV watching and being blessed. Amen.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mr. Bell. Some know me as Antone Choirboy Bell. Others know me as Elder Antone Bell. I am co-CEO of Bell Global Network, BGN TV 2090. And I want to invite you right now to get your own broadcast. Calling all ministries, all politicians, all business owners. Get your own broadcast right now, starting at $99. And if you have an idea for a TV show, we can bring your idea to reality. We have packages available that includes production and facilities. Also, we have advertising packages starting at $25. So don't hesitate. Give us a call at 313-355-7877. Once again, that's 313-355-7877 to make an appointment today.
You never ever let me down, and when I'm sinking in sin, you never ever let me drown. You're my lifeguard, my security. You took my insecurities and put me in the lion's den and took out all the fear in me and gave me unlimited, undeniable faith. In your arms, I am safe, and for that, I give you praise.
My soul says thank you. My soul says thank you.
Alice Consultation Services, LLC. Experienced professional social work practitioner. Path to a better life starts here. Two locations, Harper Woods and Detroit. We can help you improve your memory. We specialize in how to improve your memory workshops, including individual, family, group, and mental health services. Also, services includes lifestyle changes, in-home care, utilities, disability, adult daycare, nursing homes, substance abuse community resources, therapeutic training sessions, spiritual counseling. We have different payment plans to fit your needs. Call today and make an appointment. Allow us to serve you. Once again, Alice Consultation Services, LLC. For more information, call 313-615-6323. Once again, that's 313-615-6323.